How much coffee have you drank today? Coffee is one of the most favorite beverages in the planet, yet it's also addictive for some people. Some people say it good, some people say it bad, some people say it's healthy, and here is the truth. The good, the bad, and the ugly of coffee. Hi healthy people, welcome back to our favorite channel. And by the way, we changed the channel's name to How to Be Happy and Healthy. And I'm Dr. Hans, I'm a nutritionist, and now I'm gonna talk about like the good, the bad, and the ugly about coffee. Yes, like I'm sure like most of us like love to drink coffee, and some of us like afraid of drinking coffee because like we heard so many times that coffee is bad, coffee is like dangerous for our health. And now I'm gonna share to you about like the truth of coffee. Okay, are you ready? So which one do you want to hear first, the good, the bad, or the ugly? Okay, the bad. Let's talk about the bad of coffee. Okay, now we're going to talk about like the effect, the negative sides of coffee. Like because like I'm pretty sure like some of you like have heard about like officially when you got advice from your like a doctor, or maybe like your nutritionist, or maybe your influencer, yeah, that coffee is like a would be like a give negative impact for your health. So you got a concern about like a drinking coffee, especially if you are addictive already about like a coffee. Then the first bad effect of coffee is it can disrupt your biological clock, that known as like a circadian rhythm. So if you ever heard about a circadian rhythm, it's like our biological clock that can affect your sleep quality. Yeah, why? Because the substance in coffee, which is like it's not only occur on like the general coffee, also in a decaf coffee, it's proven that it's also like it's affect your quality of sleep, because it can impairs your biological clock, your circadian rhythm, yeah, by blocking your adenosine receptor. So like our body, like during the day we produce adenosine, and like when we are the end of the day, like we have like a lot of adenosine, and it makes us feel sleepy, it makes us feel tired. And coffee, by the way, yeah, it can block your adenosine receptor, so it can like makes you prevent you from getting sleepy, from getting tired. Like that's why you feel like more energetic when you drink coffee. And like when you drink coffee, it's like it's more important, because when you drink it too late, like afternoon, closer to your sleep time, bedtime, it will impact like more about like your sleep quality. So you have to be aware about this. Then the second is like coffee can add more stress to people who have chronic stress. Yeah, so why? Because caffeine especially, it can stimulate your cortisol. So cortisol is like a hormone that produced by your adrenal gland, the gland that like a sit on the top of your kidneys. So it can produce cortisol. And by the way, like I'm pretty sure that all of you like ever heard about cortisol, the hormonal stress that can like make us more stress. Yeah, but like despite of like I suggest like my patients to avoid or get rid of coffee, I think I'd prefer to like suggest them to like look for the root cause, which is the chronic stress. Because if you like get rid of your coffee and you still have like many problems, many issues, your life issues, your like family issues, like a friendship, or maybe your relationship, your career, your work, like that make you stress all day long, it will still like affect your health despite you don't drink any coffee, right? So I think like it will be better if you like solve it first, your chronic stress. But like if you drink more coffee when you are have chronic stress, it's kind of like you know, like you put fuel in that fire. You know it, right? Okay, the number three that coffee have the bad effect is coffee can trigger acid reflux. So if you got like a, if you are like a acid reflux sufferer, and maybe you are like a, you are diagnosed by GERD, yeah, like some of my patients like they have like a GERD, I think it will be make you more sufferer. Yeah, it will be like make your condition worse by drinking like more coffee. But again, I think it's like not the coffee make this like a problem. I think the GERD condition that make it as a problem. The main problem is your GERD condition. So I think it will be better if you like solve your GERD first, especially if you love coffee. Why? Because coffee can stimulate gastrin, like one of our hormone that can produce our like stomach acid excretion if you drink it. By like the mechanism is like when we taste the bitter taste of coffee, it will activate like the selective receptor like in our tongue, so it will make our gastrin produce more stomach acid. So be careful if you have like a GERD and if you love coffee. And the fourth bad things is it may cause jittery sensation, anxiety, or even sweaty, because it activates flight or fight mechanism by stimulating our adrenaline, epinephrine. It's just the same, right? But overdoing caffeine by small amount can increase baseline of anxiety or even panic attacks. So if you like to drink coffee, maybe you can like add like in a small amount gradually. It would be good. And the last thing, and it can affect your cardiac rhythm, especially for patients who already have like a heart issue, heart problem. It can cause arrhythmia. So you have to be careful with like if you are diagnosed or maybe you have history of like a cardiac or like a cardiovascular issue. Then we switch like we gotta move to the ugly of coffee. Okay, I can share you three points. What is the ugly of coffee? Right, the first one, it is the most addictive substance in the planet, just like what I said at the beginning, because it will cause like a dependency effect, and maybe like I'm one of the person that experienced it until now, because like I'm a fan of coffee. Then like it's kind of like a very hard for me to like get rid of my coffee. Like I have to consume at least one cup of coffee daily. And maybe like some of you like have the same page as me, you can comment it below. Okay, then I will not feel lonely. And it will cause like a withdrawal effect when you are like have this kind of dependency. So if you don't drink like any coffee and you like you don't want to like feel have a bad mood, you have to drink coffee to counter that withdrawal effect. Yeah, and that's what I feel as well. Yeah, I'm sorry to say it, but the ugly about coffee is it is the most chemically treated crops of all crops. Just name it: pesticide, herbicide, glyphosate, insecticide, and etc. You know, like it's like a very dangerous for our like a long-term health. So I'll suggest you, if you are like coffee lovers just like me, maybe better you got like an organic coffee to prevent all of these issues. And the last one is many people make it into unhealthy beverages. You know, I don't need to like to mention any brand of coffee. I'm pretty sure that you know it as well. Like there are many coffees, especially in my country, Indonesia. You know, then many people make it like a caramel frappuccino, caramel macchiato, then like a red velvet, and etc. And actually, there is no coffee inside it. You know, they just sell it in like a coffee shop, but that's not coffee, or maybe that is only coffee flavor, and that's not real coffee. Please, I'm sure you know about what I mean, right? Okay, so let's go about like the good of coffee, and I don't doubt about the good of coffee, because like I have read many research about like the benefit, like even like most of people like haven't heard about it. And the first one, it can increase performance, especially for like you who love sports, who love to work out, because like coffee is kind of the most studied PED, performance enhancing drugs. Yeah, why it is the most studied? Because it works. Yes, because it works. It can like increase your focus, it can increase your endurance, it can increase your speed, your strength, and etc. that related to the sports workouts, especially if you drink it about like 60 to 90 minutes before your workout. Yeah. Then second thing is like it can improve your cognitive function. How could it be? Yeah, because it helps prevent oxidation to your neurons. Yeah, your neurons, your brains, like it can improve your cognitive function through an RF2 pathway. So it's kind of like the same effect when you consume like a cruciferous vegetable. So like you will get like this pathway as well to help you like prevent Alzheimer, like a Parkinson, MS, and many other diseases that caused by neuron toxicity or neuron like a dysfunction, neuron like a degeneration, guys. So what else? The number three is like it can protect from cardiovascular disease. Well, maybe some of you like doubt about it, because doesn't coffee like trigger like a hypertension, high blood pressure, and it will like harm to people like who have cardiac issue. Well, first thing, I'm talking about like this is for healthy people, not for people who already have cardiovascular issue. So if you like still have like a healthy heart, yeah, and you want to keep it healthy in a long term, it could protect you from cardiovascular disease. How come? What's the mechanism? Yes, because coffee is acts like PCSK9 inhibitor drugs. So you don't have to know, like you don't have to like learn, but if you want to search, you can like search it like in a credible journal research study, because like recently I read about like the study about coffee, and it acts like the PCSK9 inhibitor drugs. Like this is the drugs that like we call it, we classify it as like the benign cholesterol, yeah, benign lowering cholesterol. So if you have like a high cholesterol, or we call it like hypercholesterolemia, you can take these drugs and you can lower your cholesterol, and you can have the same effect if you drink the right dose of coffee, which is like what I read is about like about 400 milligrams of 400 milligrams caffeine daily to make this kind of effect. Then it can make your liver more effective of recycling cholesterol. Yeah, cholesterol that like carrying lipoprotein, and even LDL, the one like that many people call it as a bad cholesterol. And well, it's not that bad actually. And I have explained it. I have like elaborated it like many times in my previous contents, and you can watch it if you want to like learn about it. Then so that's why like when people like regularly drink the right coffee, not the sugary coffee, it could like you know, help you to protect you again like a hypercholesterolemia. It can like fix your cholesterol issues if you have like a bad profile cholesterol, which is like a high triglycerides, maybe like a high small dense LDL, a low HDL. It can fix your cholesterol profile. Okay, next, The number four, the good of coffee, is it can lower risk of gallstones and even kidney stones. Because it can stimulate the bile production, it can help thins the bile. If you haven't heard the bile is like a liquid that can like it can clean the grease, like a clean like the fat, the over consumption of fat when we eat like a oily greasy food, like we need bile to clean out that kind of excess fat in our body by having bile. And it can also improve kidney function by increasing our GFR, glomerulus filtration rate. So that's why it can like prevent kidney stones. And the last and but not least about the good of coffee is it can prevent metabolic syndrome. So if you ever heard about like insulin resistance, I've talked a lot about it, then it can like treat like a high blood glucose, high blood pressure, hypercholesterolemia, and etc. that we classify it as metabolic syndrome. Coffee, drinking the right coffee, can help you to prevent this metabolic syndrome because it is hepatoprotective coffee. So it can like prevent you like to get a complication from getting fatty liver. It can like decrease your risk of getting fatty liver and etc. So many of my patients ask me a lot about like how much is too much about like drinking coffee, because like from the studies that I have read and collected until now, like the best amount, like if you want to get all the health benefit that I've said in this video, is about like the maximum is 400 milligram of caffeine from all the drinks, all the beverages that you drink daily. Okay, then the second is like these studies, all the studies result is for most people, not everyone. So you have to find out about yourself whether you are like a good metabolizers of like a coffee, if you maybe you have like a caffeine sensitivity, if maybe you have like a slow metabolize of like a consuming coffee, and maybe you got like a poor metabolic in general. So you have to find out about yourself, because like we couldn't say that if it's good for you, then it would be like good for everyone. It will just like if it's good for me, and even like many studies say that it's good, it has like many benefits, many health benefits. But if you like try it yourself, you experience yourself that coffee is not good for you, don't drink it. Right? Yeah, because everyone is unique, everyone is different. But what I want to say here in this video is that I want to like just share about like all the good things, all the bad things, all the ugly things that you have to, that you can like more beware about drinking coffee, especially if you are a coffee lover just like me. Thank you, see you, and stay healthy.